done.
Okay. Yes. First speaker is Alexander Managadze. Title is Neo Radiography. Absorption while passing through matter, but muons instead of X-rays and the rock or building materials instead of human flesh. Also, sensitive device is necessary. Advantage of the method are its non-invasiveness and employment of natural origin of radiation. First time, the idea of cosmic ray muon flux application for detection of density fluctuations in the structure of archaeological objects was arisen about 40 years ago due to Luis Alvarez. This idea was employed for secret chamber search in Khafre pyramids. There were used two streamer chamber, but researchers determined the absence of secret cavities in the pyramid body. Here you see more detailed scheme of experiment, and here you can see difference between observed results and the suggested existence of empty secret chamber. In some sense, this general scheme of experiment is actual in the present time too. You know that muon radiography is used in volcanology. Here you can see practically cosmic ray photograph of a volcano in Japan. It's a real image. Here you can see the scheme of experiment. Detector is here, and investigated object is here. You see muon fluxes, and the same detector also can detect the opposite muon fluxes to compare original muon fluxes. here is the results of this experiment, density map of this object, and it is usual map of this boundary. Also, muon tomography method can be used for inspection of the condition of huge industrial objects. Rigids, dams, blast furnaces, and so on, when it is necessary to estimate technical state of safety of such bodies. For example, crack appearance, construction conditions, groundwater level, and so on. Here I would like to show you real such industrial object in Russia. Here is gas underground storage, and near it here is borehole. We hope in Russia to use such object for testing muon radiography method, but unfortunately it wasn't done by administrative reasons. Also we had second project to investigate the bottom of some famous lake. Here you see Plesheva Lake near Perislav Zavetsky, and here you can see scheme of depth level of this lake. Near lake there are many bore holes, and it could be also good object for testing muon radiography method, but it wasn't done because by our estimation, difference of densities of ground density near lake and water density was not so big for successful picture. Previous reporter already told about use of muon tomography for nuclear reactors. Maybe I could show only another variant of picture. Here is angular scan of muon tomography results after exposition 7 square meters day. It is possible to see that no big damage in reactor core exists. But more new employment of muon radiography is exploration of Mars geology. Muons generated by interaction of primary cosmic rays in the planet's atmosphere pass through a geological objects of interest and are partially absorbed by the object. A passive muon detector composed of parallel scintillating plates on a lander or on a rover records tracks of the muons, and the recorded tracks are analyzed on site to determine the direction from which they entered the detector and the amount of energy absorbed by the target. here is a variant of muon radiography instrument mounted as a secondary instrument on a rover, Marsaход. And here is the instrument is mounted on a small lander absorbing multiple targets during the life of the mission. Potential primary target for muon radiography exploration on Mars is possible to see here. Such geological structures contains lava tubes and caves in the subsurface, and muon radiography obtained from here would be used to map the void space associated with partially collapsed lava tubes. Now it was short review of possibilities for muon tomography. Here, few words about nuclear emulsion as a suitable detector for muon radiography. Left side, you can see features of nuclear emulsion. Precise muon tracking, high resolutions, minimal infrastructure for service, no electric power, usable in difficult locations, unusable in warm season, and air limited by its scanning power. And for plastic scintillators, analyzes in real time, long exposures possible. You see this comparison. And now I would like to tell about muon radiography test of nuclear emulsion detector method. This test was carried out by Relativistic Physical Institute and by Moscow State University. Emulsion stacks were inserted within the body of steel metal column around 3 meter height in accelerator frame in accelerator belonging to Moscow State University. Here is you see this steel column, which is the part of accelerator frame. Accelerator as a device, as an instrument, is not important here. It was only some huge, massive object. exposition was 49 days. The weight of this steel column is about 23 tons. Here is, you see some cavity, some slit. Just our emulsion stacks was placed here. Here is, you see photo of this place. And scheme of location of emulsion stacks inside the body of column and outside. Emulsion stacks. We used for these emulsion stacks both Slavic emulsion and Fuji opera emulsion. Maybe scheme of stacks maybe not so important in Russian. Yes. Here is the process of installation emulsion stacks inside the slit of steel column here and here. Assumption about neon flux was like this. Then by our estimation difference, because muon intensity fluxes outside and under ion was around 10. Here you can see microscopic stage in Moscow State University with nuclear Marshall plate. And here is our results. Line is for calculations. Blue dots for primary results. Open circles is for results with deduction of background, and you see that this agreement is rather good. Special distribution of muon flux is measured in this test experiment and calculated non-uniformity caused by huge solid absorber agree rather satisfactorily. That shows muon radiography capability. It is necessary to take into account that some procedure corrections in experiment realization are required. It was results of our experiment. In this year, we are carrying out other tests with the same purpose. This time, emulsion stacks were placed near two huge steel discs in the building of industrial plant in Moscow. You can see here picture of these huge steel discs, which is good test objects. Here you can see scheme of experiment. The weight of such steel disc is about 40 tons. Here you can see object, investigated object, and installation of stack here. This was installed horizontally, and this was installed with slope 45 degree. We hope to find better way out. Exposition will be continued longer than 4 months. It is not finished yet. And we hope to elaborate the procedures of such data treatment and the extraction of the object image. Practically, that's all.
Are there any questions or comments?
Operation. collaboration with colleagues from Tokyo, from a group of Professor Tanaka. And I want to mention that for the scanning, for the analysis of all this data, we used the scanning system I presented this morning. And special thanks, let's say, for this development from Andrei Alexandrov and from Mikhail Vladimirov from Lebedev Institute, who was main contributor for this job. Mikhail, I did not mention this morning, he is a developer of GPU, GPU processing for us. Okay, so I will say about nuclear emulsion laboratories in Italy. Recent muon radiography project which we participated. And scope, especially on the Stromboli exposure, which was done from October 2011 up to March of 2012. And it was completely organized, the process, and analyzed by us, by Damian Wood. Potential and prospective of muonography with nuclear emulsion in Italy. Here I start to use this new term, muonography, was introduced by Professor Tanaka. It's quite common. Okay, emulsion projects and laboratories in Italy, and well, it's presented already this morning. My business for us is neutrino experiments, course, and then opera experiment. Emulsion scanning laboratories, Naples, Salerno, Gran Sasso, Bari, Bologna, Padova. And about photo scanning systems are constructed for opera scanning. Since 2011, some laboratories are involved in muonography projects in Naples, Salerno, and Gran Sasso. This is about opera. Everything was already told about opera. I just show this is a brick which. Then after disassembling becomes the emulsions, where you go through all the scanning. And what is interesting to note, maybe, that we have an opera where almost 9 million of emulsion films with total emulsion sensitive surface of 200,000 square meters. So it's very muonography motion projects where we participated in the analysis of on-zen data. The exposure was done by Tanaka's group. We organized and analyzed data from Stromboli. And actually, emulsions were installed and exposed, but not yet analyzed for data summit. Last year. The principle of muon radiography, it was also already said. I just mentioned that all the nearly horizontal atmospheric muons are useful for muon radiography volcanoes. And this method is limited to upper part of the mountain above the detector, obviously. And low muons are even not able to have short exposure months, the typical time scale. And 1 kilometer of rock thickness is an approximate upper limit for 1 or 2 square meter detectors for this reason, low density of cosmic rays. It's assumed that muon flux in spectrum alone is nearly constant. Assumed to a precise knowledge about the mountain shape, so we need to have the digital elevation map of the mountain. What we can obtain is the angular map of the average rock density using the muon absorption information. And the detector should provide a precise angle for each particle passes through. So for this reason, we can use them also. Moreover, it has a number of advantages in respect to our detectors. Motivations for the Stromboli explosion. Even if Stromboli is one of the most known and most active volcanoes in the world, and a great amount conventional technological equipment, and basically seismic and this kind of stuff. But the exact internal structure of the region below craters is not well understood yet. Actually, there are several theories, which try to explain in detail the Strombolian activity. Just to remind you that Strombolian took eruption approximately 20 minutes, very small eruptions. And actually, there is quite complex crater region where are three craters. And this can be explained by the system of cracks of fissures under the crater region. So this in details is explained in this paper. It's written among the physicists and methodologists. And what is important for membranography that this cracks also can be of order of magnitude of 10 meters in diameter. So actually, it's impossible to detect with traditional geological survey and volcanological survey methods like seismic and so on, because the resolution is never reached 10 meters. And even for the radiography, it's challenging, actually. But it's possible. In this picture, there are several images of Stromboli. This is some history that the volcano slopes was curled in the past and it becomes asymmetric. So this is a crater region, it is not on the top, but on the slope. And this slope calls so-called Chara del Foco, which means something like flying falling, and you can imagine why it calls like that. And this region also important because sometimes it happened that some faults, and then can produce a kind of tsunami also, as it happens in small, let's say, but dangerous for the nearest islands and for Stromboli itself. And actually it's happened in 2002, if I remember well. So, the problem was to find a good place for explorers, and actually they found this one in May of 2011. It was a special survey of the island, and it practically was the only option. It's relatively late the stable for detect installation. This is the view on the crater region from this place. The paper will be positioned on this altitude, and the crater region is on this. And this slope is Chara del Foco. View from top. Power detector and angular acceptance and region of interest. This is the cross section of. The island on maybe this line approximately, and you see that unfortunately it is not so sharp island, and you have also some structure after the crater region, which of course it's also a material which means should pass before the detector, and considering this distance and this amount of material and the resolution of 10 meters which we need to obtain, it becomes really challenging for you. Okay, this this is a scheme of the emulsion model which we prepared. Actually, so this structure is quite simple. We have the central plane of stainless steel, where we stick from both sides two emulsion plates from here and two from here. Each emulsion plate was closest into envelope for light isolation. And all this stuff was in a metal box with two stainless steel plates in the side and aluminum frame around. Everything was hermetically closed using the O-ring. And so one model accommodated 10 cells, let's say. Its cell consists of four plates. And the size and the weight you see on this plot. Actually, we produce 8 models like that, and the total each metal plate was of 5 millimeter of stainless steel. The total weight of this stuff was about 250 kilograms, and active area is of about 1 square meter. So this is the photo which was done in the mass extraction, and you see one model which is opened and emulsion envelopes are in good condition. So it was working also. This is the photo of the detector during the disassembling phase. You see the mount and the hand, and we have 8 models like I shown in the previous slide, the frame, and some additional instruments which we installed, like GPS, well, it was installed only during the installation for the positioning. And it was also movement sensor. It was quite optional, but it was interesting to see if any seismic activity which was enough to move our device, because of course the detector should be in a fixed position during the exposure. Okay, this is another photo from another site. It's actually before disassembling. And this, we had to put special protection. The detector was outside, completely outside, so exposed to the sun. And this is the sun was coming from this side, this is the sun. And to protect it, we put a special thermal protection with actually with X-clay sacks and with armatex. The detector was exposed in winter months, and actually, there is no plot, but the mean temperature during this period never exceeded 15 degrees, the mean for the day. But of course, it was with peaks, and but with this protection, we get good thermal stability of the detector. So follows more or less than the mean temperature. Okay. We put a special attention to get a precise positioning and orientation of the detector. Actually, we installed some fixed vertices on the floor before the detector disassembling. Make a measurement, a precise measurement of the distance between this vertex and the detector surface to keep memory about the detector position, because it was not obvious for us if one or two days of GPS exposure will be enough to get the required precision. We get the orientation using here and our here, and the accuracy which we obtained finally, it was of the order of a few millimeters for each one, which is enough for precise orientation. Okay, this is a digital elevation map. Actually, it was not immediately completed up to date, because actually Vulcan is active and the shape is not completely stable. So the digital elevation map, which we have of 2 years old, was not really did not really precisely follow the photos. And this is the map, this is the photo. Actually, this map is up to date. It was done just 1 month after our exposure, actually, so it was very up to date. And you see a perfect coincidence of the photo. And these are two superimposers, so you see almost perfect coincidence of them and the photograph. And also, presented in this way, you can see the near shape, which is also inside. So it means our good understanding about positioning and orientation. The photo was done from detector position. And about the rock thickness, this is the rock thickness which we should pass muon to get to our detector. This is our data which we get, which we obtain. So this is the mountain, this is the cosmic from the free sky, from the opposite side. And well, here it is not so well visible the shape on this picture, but if we do the differential plot, so I just subtract from the sky the mountain, and I get the absorbed part of the emulsion spectrum, of the muon spectrum, and you see perfectly the emulsion shape, the mountain shape, and it coincides quite well with them visible from the detector position. So from what we have seen also on the previous plots, comparison with photos. Okay. This is the simulation of a moon flux. Which arrived to our detector in the exposure time, and well, 1.12 square meters is just 1 molar of our age, and this is what we would see in 1 molar. So the mountain starts here, and we can see only this part with 3 molars out of 8, with 6 models out of 5, so this corresponds more or less to the statistics which we have up to now, because not all data are integrated yet into analysis. This is the performance, let's say the discovery performance of our detector of 1 square meter. And this is the hypothetical detector of 10 square meters, so it would see almost everything on this altitude. And this is the data in the Monte Carlo comparison. So this is our data, this is the Monte Carlo, and if we normalize and subtract, this is the difference between both. this corresponds to the increase to the excess of the muons, and this can be interpreted as the empty space. So, and it's perfectly logic because it's a crater region, and craters, most part of time, are empty. So we start to see something which is not only the shape of a mountain. We start to see something inside. Of course, this data is not I must note that here on this plot, the bean size are 10 milliradians, 10 by 10. So it's quite fine bean. Because we need it for to hope to see this, this structure, this, this cracks. This data could be improved. Well, I didn't mention, but this was unfolded, of course, with our efficiency, with our angular efficiency dependence, which we estimated using the Q factor in four plates, let's say. And this estimation can be improved, I think, and also our efficiency can be improved because it's just the first step of the analysis. Also, this is just 6 of 8 models. So when we add the full statistics, we will see, we hope to see something more. So, a few words about the nuclear emulsion as a detector for muon river in general. So, the advantages and the disadvantages. Advantages is perfect basic angular resolution, which is better than 2 milliradians. It's compact and easy to transport, no increase is required, can be installed in practice. One more advantage, which is not negligible, which is modular, and can be installed inside any kind of locations and can be easily split. So it's, for example, we put all models together because we had enough space, but in principle we can split on the detectors of small size and put in different places. And this is, generally speaking, not possible with electronic detectors. This advantage is, so we have no time information, and even complicated and time-consuming data acquisition, it's a main drawback, and that's required special instrument systems. Accepted temperature range for open exposure should be below 25 degrees, but actually this limit usually has any kind of detectors. And simple, a single user sensitive part. This is actually the significant disadvantage of the monster because each detector is unique and can have unique properties. This detector and the detector are able to provide information to the master and to parameters usage for processor. Prospective and potential promotion network in Italy. So currently, it's a byproduct of the technology developed for nuclear physics, for water in particular. The current power usage in Italy for all this analysis presented above is equivalent to just two scanning systems, usage of 50% of time. And the recent scanning speed usage for this analysis was 20 square centimeters per hour per layer. So minimum time required for full analysis scanning of stromboli-like detector, which is 1 square meter per 4 vouchers per layer, so each layer, is of 170 days with these conditions. But in the near future, of 1 to 2 years, when opera load will go down, the level of scanning power may become about 10-20 scanning systems available for human radiography. And this means factor future speed up. And scanning systems hardware upgrade is coming, and seen my presentation, with additional factor of 5 minimum incremental scan speed. So in a short time scale, we can acquire potential to perform analysis of 1 square meter of motion telescope in just a few days. And this makes emulsions an attractive point also to launch scale muon telescopes, multi-context exposure, and for industrial applications. Okay, thank you.
Questions or comments?
May I ask you about construction of emulsion stack? Why you use metal plate between emulsion layer and also rubber layer? Sutin slide. Sutin. This one, yes. Metal plates 5 millimeters between emulsion and elastic rubber layers. Top and bottom.
Okay, so there are several reasons. One is the flatness, because this detector should be possibly flat with the accuracy of possibly 1 or 2 milliradians.
Understand? I mean inside.
So yes. This is actually the reference. This is the good one. These two were not special attention for precise flatness of this material. So this is the flat one, and the emulsions are sticked to this plate. Rather, it's necessary to push, just to push the emulsions into up to the central plate. To push them and for some protection. External plates was of also 5 millimeter. It's to protect from the low energy radiation, let's say, of low energy electron photons and of natural environment radiation. And this is one reason, flatness. Another reason to cut out the low energy component, because we recognize threats in the envelope of all these four plates, and actually with 5 millimeters of iron, we can easily cut out everything below, at least below 1 GeV. Maybe, well, let's say we cannot cut out 10 GeV for sure. It's strange for us. But 1 GeV we cut for sure, and in between there will be some, let's say, intermediate region.
Okay, thank you.
Other questions?
To cool down the emulsion, you can use a refrigerator, mini bar. With solar batteries.
Yes, I imagine wherever your mini bar. Actually, it was really hard to arrive here, and the detector structure was bring by helicopter.
What about inner structure, Trambali? I believe that there are some map. What about maximum depths of knowledge of this direction? Do you have such information?
Well, I know that there is known just that the channel is inclined to be complete, and some basic information about the domain. What I'm looking for actually is some cracks which are under this surface. And
discussion? Okay, let's thank speaker. The last speaker is Chernyavskiy, investigation of Newton Morales double data decay in nuclear energy.
About nature of neutrino arise by Majorana. And question is, has a neutrino mass or no? And this problem has now more than 75 years. Here is a team from Radioactive Institute and Institute of Experimental Theoretical Physics, which don't want. We applied emulsion, applied for this problem, nuclear emulsion, filled with molybdenum powder. Here is an example of old publication in which some limits of this process was established. You see that numbers are very big at that time. This problem people tried to solve by different techniques, by electronic detectors, semiconductor detectors, geochemical processes, and now these limits are about 10 to 24 years. And last year our experiments on neutrino oscillation give some hopes that this process really exists. And neutrino has mass and a lepton number not conserved. We had some technical methodical investigation before this experiment. The 10 plates was prepared with molybdenum. It looks like that in microscope. Here is a grains of molybdenum conglomerate. We investigated the question, does it spoil or not from chemical point of view features of emulsion? It doesn't spoil, and moreover it don't prevent to measure tracks in emulsion. This is distribution of size of this conglomerate of molybdenum and distribution on the depths in the mass. You have to get this distribution must be uniform. So we have to turn emulsion during dry. And when grains are rather rather small, you can increase the concentration of this molybdenum grain for two times. Here is some estimation of necessary amount of molybdenum and emulsion. For 1 kilogram of molybdenum, we can prepare about 570 emulsion layers. And if we measure on the 3 microscope, 1 layer per day, so for 1 year we can get evaluation about 1.5, 10 to 24 years result. There is, of course, a background process. For example, potassium, which is always is in gelatin, and some strontium isotopes, which have a very short period of life. Here is artificial pictures in which two real photo overloaded in each other. It is electrons. First is our emulsion with grains of molybdenum. So it will be looks like a real event view looks like that. So it is only an illustration. There will be also kinematical background. When we measure tracks of electron, it not always straight lines. It is very curved trick, and our task is to find intersection point. And it is often not intersect in one plate, only projection is intersecting. So we consider as intersection point minimal distance in projection of two tracks of electrons, and we evaluate that size of this distance d is rather small, 1.6 microns, and about 80% of events has a size less than 8.8 microns. And there are no correlation between this distance, which we take as intersection point, and divergence angle between two tracks. How to exclude the background from potassium or natural isotopes of uranium, thorium, and actinium. Potassium we can purify. There is chemical processes which can do concentration maybe 3 orders less than usual. see neglectable amount of this energy caused by potassium. And in our amount of emulsion with molybdenum, we can get some background event also caused by natural elements, radioactive elements. But this element, first step of radioactive chain, is decay with emission of alpha particles. So, and next daughter element also emit alpha particle, and only last maybe isotope can emit electrons or gamma rays. So it looks like 3-5 beams star in a march. And it is very simple to see it and classify it as a radioactive star. So we used 10-12 chambers with molybdenum and did some evaluation of background and condition of experiment, and have estimation that during 1 year with kilogram of molybdenum, we can reach limitation about 10 to 24 years. And when we measure energy of electrons and or charged particles, we did some special work about measurements of energy from muons, from p mu neutrino decays, and get this value. And it is very good reaction because muons has a monochromatic energy, and accuracy is like that. So it is enough for our measurements.
Are there any questions?
But how you prove that you have simultaneous single event emission? You have no time.
Of course, it is not simultaneous emission of electrons in and other background also. We used some geometrical estimation the probability of intersection of these tracks inside this distance d.
But in our case,
small.
In our case with gallium 8, we have emission from the same point of stopped nucleus. So it is sequential beta decay. Time is needed.
In helium, you have two electrons.
Helium 8 has sequential decay. Lithium 8 and in the same point. It is perfect.
You will see helium 8 how it looks like.
Tomorrow.
Energy which.
About decay 8 MeV electrons, I think. Few MeV electrons.
We have some 2.8 MeV. It is not necessary. It is each night neutron decays independently inside nuclei.
So
they coincide in time and interact with neutrino antineutrino. It is issued, it is absorbed in time. But no necessary conservation of flow. No, no.
This electron could work in emulsion to keep the position of the molecule.
About turning?
How about to paint the base product? This pouring will be started for them, and including molybdenum pouring on this upper layer. How it spreads them?
I don't know. Maybe there is this mechanism due to gravity. It is molybdenum is heavy,
yes,
so yes, you have to stir. Yes,
yes. I know, but after the first layer is dried, then you for the next layer, including molybdenum and last you for that is right. Last you dry the cold layer.
No. Molybdenum include in gel. In state of preparing gel.
In process of gel. Yes, yes. Before.
After that covering. So we
glass. Doing on glass.
Yes.
On glass plate.
Not molybdenum on glass. Molybdenum in gel.
Yes, yes.
After that, mix it and cover it on glass.
Lack of operant films. Interference layer.
Yes,
I
know. We never before opera. Don't use emulsion with thickness 50 microns, which prepared like two layers. For example, we use in EMU-15 experiment emulsion covered on a plastic base with thickness 50 microns. One layer. The same here. One layer, not two.
Yes. But one layer causes question.
Михаил Ильич, я не знаю, в чем проблема, что за материал
работает? Я не пойму, ну, поскольку я не могу видеть, я не поливал.
Нет, я не понимаю, что в чем. You mean uniform?
Вот из него пусть ел. Aqua layer
emulsion from the one side. We don't turn out. Emulsion on, for this experiment, we cover emulsion on the glass with thickness 50 microns without turning and back covering.
For a time, for a short time, because it is not fall to glass. And then again.
Вер, разве мы переворачивали? Полили и все. Нет, 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 нет. No, 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 not, not to now. No. Нет, нет. Олег Павлович. Не переворачивали. Полили 50 микрон с молибденом. И все. Не, не, 50 микрон. No, no. We, sorry, we cannot understand the question. What problem? After. Okay.
Other questions? Comments? Okay, thank you very much.
Михаил Михайлович, объявление.